We are so excited to be a part of this day. It's one of the most exciting days on the calendar. And there are big names on the block. It was something that we've all talked about leading up to this. Those that haven't followed as closely and those that have know these are some of the big names that expect to be moved today, or at least there are hopes in that direction. Mark Stone, Wayne Simmonds, Derek Brassard, Kevin Hayes, Eric Staal. At the bottom of this graphic, Sergei Bobrovsky, Artemi Panarin, the Columbus Blue Jackets, so much discussion surrounding that club. And then today, turn to our resident goalie here, Kevin Weeks. We've got a goalie on the move there, Keith Kinkaid from the Devils. Why?
Well, I spoke to his agent, Alain Roy, and he said that this is an opportunity for him to have an extended season. Now, when you look at Keith Kinkaid, he's really established himself as an everyday NHL goalie. He's played very well in New Jersey overall, not quite to the same clip this year as last season, but he's definitely a legit NHL goaltender. He's very beloved by his teammates, by the fans. He's become really professional, and I've got to tell you, Rolly Melanson's done a great job with him in New Jersey. This has afforded him this opportunity to be able to go to Columbus, which I really believe is a contender. We'll get more into that later. And add some insurance to them. This is an insurance policy. I got to credit Jarmo Kekalainen for going out, realizing that he has, I believe, a high-end team and assuring themselves some certainty. You get that goalie lots, an insurance policy rather, in Keith Kinkaid, who I think can help stabilize things should something happen by way of an injury. So this is a good move for them.
I certainly find it a curious move, particularly with J.F. Berube playing so well for Cleveland. Could they potentially be moving a guy like Bob? Could we all have been snookered a little bit by the Columbus Blue Jackets? And by the end of the day, could we see Panarin and Bob move? That's a question we got to watch really closely. I don't know the answer to it. I've felt like they're all in. But yet, when I look at the Blue Jackets reserve list from top to bottom, they've extended themselves quite a bit here. The assets are not really there moving forward. Is it really all about the playoffs this year? Or are they just setting up to potentially bring back a boatload of assets as well? That's the number one story I'm going to be following today, guys.
And to bookend that, from the Devils' perspective, I just spoke to Ray Shiro, their general manager. He said Mackenzie Blackwood has been really impressive.
Oh, yeah.
We've expected a lot of him since his time in Barrie in the OHL. I think he's an outstanding young goalie. He's gotten better. He's come up and made a seamless transition. So nice to have him earn the opportunity by way of how well he's played. Corey Schneider starting to regain his form, too. So that's it from the Devils' point of view, just up the turnpike.
And we know the Devils went to the playoffs last year. For Columbus, playoffs last 2 years. First time in franchise history, they've done that. And lots touching on what the immediate future looks like for them. The next three drafts, this is how their picks lay out. 2019, it looks like it's going to be a ways of a wait
you
for them.
You don't have to show up on time for 2019, Tony.
How about that? Yeah,
they've
no kidding.
You can see there. Okay, it's when you look even at their minor league team and the prospects that they have, they've had to extend themselves in that area, obviously, to bring in a guy like Matt Duchene and DeZingel. And are they done yet? I don't know. I think it's a strong possibility that one of the Breadman or Bob gets traded today.
I will say this for the Jackets. Having John Madden as their American League head coach down in Cleveland, he's done a really good job. He's had an excellent career. He's got a lot of insight that he can provide. Jarmo Kekalainen's roots are as a scout. So if you are going to find some of those late-round gems, which they're going to have to by way of this 2019 draft, I'm not too worried about that. I'm not too concerned. They are a contender. Columbus is for real. I've been saying it all year. I've told John Davidson. I told Jarmo Kekalainen. That team's a contender, lots.
There's no doubt that their odds have gone up significantly with these most recent moves. They got to feel good about that. So who knows? Maybe they will stay pat. But the Kinkaid, that's really got my eyes raised up just a little bit in terms of that move.
Jackets fans, fire the cannon. They have not advanced in the postseason. Perhaps this is the year. They're certainly doing everything they can.